Oh, is your spouse or partner number one in your life? Or is it your smartphone? Come on, fess up. Try going 24 hours without your smartphone. You may discover you can't. And that's phone addiction, everybody. And Dr. Rachel Glick is here with a wake-up call for all of your hang-ups when it comes to your phone. And I just got to say, Siri, I love you. See, she talks back to me.
That's sweet, Pertz.
Isn't that something?
Oh, I mean, it's a virtual relationship here. Mm-hmm. And you run into this all the time.
Absolutely.
Tell me about some of the problems couples are having.
Well, it comes up in sessions with couples a lot where they're like, I can't connect with you. You're always on your phone. But recently I was talking with somebody that really shed some light on a neediness that can be created, that it was really triggering his insecurity because of the access that he could be connecting to his wife at all times. And why wasn't she replying back?
Oh yeah, that's another part of the problem mm-hmm. too. Well, Randy was showing me a tweet this morning. Somebody walked into a restaurant and thought everybody was praying. Mm-hmm. Realized they were all working on their little table in the restaurant with their smartphones.
Yeah.
Yeah. So people aren't really communicating, even though they are kind of communicating, but in a different way.
I mean, in certain ways, definitely phones allow us to be more connected with one another or be in touch, but we're losing a connection within ourselves in a way that's really present, and that's what allows us to be connected with other people is when we're really in a place where we're comfortable being within ourselves and the quiet, or not just seeking something externally to fill us up or stimulate us, and that's where we run into problems.
We even have a couple of generations now that are having to take courses on how to look somebody in the eye and actually talk to them, you know?
Exactly.
Yeah, so what advice do you have?
Well, the first thing is to create some boundaries. Decide for yourself with your family or with your spouse or your partner what kind of boundaries you want to create, that either times or zones where the phone isn't present.
So not at the dinner table.
Yeah, and if that's what you decide to do. It could be that it's a couple hours at night. It could be that you take a whole day off for the week.
Not in the bedroom.
Well, yeah, and each person needs to decide what works for them, but some sort of conscious boundary that it's not present. And once you're away from it, you start to calm your nervous system down, and you can really see that you might open up to other things that you would enjoy doing.
Would you suggest, if let's say somebody goes on vacation, wean yourself off the phone then?
That's a great opportunity.
Stress,
yes.
You know?
Like deliberately leave it behind. That mm-hmm. can also, at first you might feel anxious, but then you start to feel very liberated. Mm-hmm. But it's also really important. Much of the time we focus on the phone, we're really not connecting with being present within ourselves. So, and there's a pain that comes with that. It's like we look to it to avoid boredom or anxiety or maybe feeling insecure or empty. And so being more present with how we feel and being able to tolerate that little bit of discomfort helps us get over really a lot of addictions.
Some good information there, Dr. Glick. Thank you so much.
My
we
pleasure.
Appreciate it. And on that note, we're going to take a little break and we're going to try to wean ourselves off these things. We'll be right back.